and horizontal. And then they put stones so that this water starts percolating to the side rather than collecting. And very good news, our statistics shows not a big impact, but we decrease 16% in malaria rate. At least with 16% of a big population, we decrease 16%. So we are trying. Our best bit is not to throw waste, and our, you know, Swachh Bharat, we are working with Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and we tell them to put waste, the good waste for the fertilizer, to make the fertilizer out of it, and the other waste, separate waste, which we are working with, of course, Narendra Modi has been such an inspirer for all of us. And the treatment, and the treatment of common and prevalent diseases in the area. So who does this? Does anybody know who does this?
Eco.
Health Sevika. We appoint one woman from the village. We train them every 3 months. And she goes from door to door, called Health Sevika, gets about only 1,000 rupees. I mean, you know, what in India these days, 1,000 rupees is nothing. She gets 1,000 rupees. She goes with her backpack or sometime in a bicycle. Next slide. And she goes and takes her medicines and charts and things like that every single day. And 10 Sevikas are overviewed by Sanyojika, and she gets 1,500 rupees a month. Next slide. Go back. Go back. So that is about prevention, the telemedicine. 4 years ago, I came across a doctor named Dr. Acharya from the Johns Hopkins. And he was giving a lecture that how to give a quality care medicine to villages, and it touched my heart. Although telemedicine is a very expensive project at the moment, but you know, India is growing by leaps and bounds for technology in in the IT. So we decided to go with Dr. Acharya. He wanted somebody to do groundwork, and he wanted to put his software for the India. So I said, God, Johns Hopkins. So I grabbed it, and we started. And on December of 2017, we inaugurated a project in Bhubaneswar. Reason we did it in Bhubaneswar, we have a team strong enough of doctors who will support this project. Now, telemedicine project is now 1 year old, and what we found, the patients used to go 16 to 42 kilometers to go to primary health center. Now they have telemedicine center in their area. There are 3 telemedicine centers in Bhubaneswar. I went and visited there, and I was so thrilled that these are the villages where, the, as I told even before, elephant comes every evening to eat rice paddy. Every evening, Bhalu comes. And these are the villages where we have 3 centers. The patients now don't have to go 42 kilometers to primary health center by government. There are about, we also have now 99.3% patient satisfaction. The doctors are getting little easier and easier, because it's not easy to treat patient. If I want to treat a patient, if I am in front of her, it's a lot easier. But when you have to treat the patient through the IT or through the tablet, it's not easy. So, but now, after 1 year, we find doctors are getting more used to it. The Sanyojika is getting more, little more efficient. You know, remember, it's so simple to know what is telemedicine. But it took us 1 year to get ready, and now in a year, so everything takes time. But we are very, very happy with Johns Hopkins there, and it's expensive. But 2% of MBBS goes to cover 70% of villages. Only 2%. So doctors don't go. Who teaches them? Quacks. Jhoori laga ke, chalo, bhoot nikalo, bhoot nikalo, bhoot nikalo, and they die. So I think this telemedicine is a quality medicine, the future of India. And ek karne ke baad, there was a doctor from Delhi came to us, use my software, it will be very cheap. So we started the second telemedicine center last month in Jharkhand. 3 more. Wow. So three in Bhubaneswar, three last month started in the Jharkhand, and it is the different technology, different software. But you know, this is the, then two companies came along. And you know, there is a, if in India, if company makes 1 crore, they have to give 2% of their income to called CSR, community social, you know, share. So two companies have come up. One from Indore, there is a company called Kawasaki Cars. They want to do now telemedicine in Indore. And the fourth person called Indectotherm, they are partly here and partly in India, and they might help us to do another telemedicine in Gujarat. So we will talk more about telemedicine. I want to show you, go the couple of slides further. Keep going, keep going. This boy, do you see this boy? And do you see the scar here? He was attacked by Bhalu. So because of our telemedicine, he was immediately transported to the Bhubaneswar Medical Center and he lived. Otherwise, his brain was sticking out. So that is the telemedicine Sanyojika. That is the boy. So you can imagine, this is the telemedicine Sanyojika taking weight and doing the first aid and things like that. She does as best as she can. But the beauty is, the doctor can be 1,000 miles away and still they get the good treatment. And that is the beauty of telemedicine. Even if telemedicine is expensive, we think it is a future for quality medicine for villages. Go back to the second slide, previous one. Okay, so telemedicine. Eye health has a separate talk I'll give you later on, but we have a greatest donor for eye health here, and we'll have a separate session for it. Next one. Anemia, we will see the video, so I'm not telling too much. Anemia project is going on well. And why it is important? Can anybody say why we need to treat anemia? What improvement it does? Can anybody say? Don't be afraid. This is like we are friends.
It needs more iron.
It needs more iron and
overall health.
Overall health, absolutely. But one thing, people judge how good you are in medicine from maternal and infant mortality. Maternal mortality was so high in India. In 1993, it was 330, while in America, it is 4 per 100,000 live birth. So lot of attention is given that mother dies during the labor and delivery process. And from obstetric cause, we had to decrease. If mother is anemic, she bleeds during labor and delivery, and then she gets infected and dies. So this has helped maternal mortality, and the present maternal mortality is 126 from 230. It's a great improvement. We still have a long way to go. Same thing with children. Their brain doesn't develop. They are not healthy. So we are trying our best. But you know, as money comes, we found out that even iron tablets are not cheap. The first 2 years we did a project, and 86% of women were anemic. Out of 86%, 82 we improved with iron and education and good food and all. But then we ran out of iron. So now we find, we give them a good education. We tell them to eat green vegetables, chana and gur, and cook in the iron utensil. And by that, we have improved 70%. But whatever money you people are giving, I'm sending to India for anemia, and they really, really, really use carefully. The last, one more project is dental care. We just started 3 years ago. He is not here, Dr. Malik. He is our dentist. He goes to India every year. And he did 3 years of dental care. And we are going to improve, because pyaria is very common. And other thing is, people are eating this gutkha and all. So the cancer of mouth has become a big issue now. It is a new issue. Before it wasn't there, but now, not only lung and prostate for men, but the mouth. So that's why we are also taking the dental. Now, what are the things we do in this country? From this country, we do pre-medical exchange program, which Tanay, our greatest